But it was Miles's earlier recordings with Charlie Parker that caught the attention of a young independent producer, Bob Weinstock, who had his own record label, Prestige.
I had a record store, Jazz Record Corner, in New York City on West 47th Street. And there I first heard about Miles Davis on the Dial recordings, and I was very impressed by him. He liked me because I was talking about his records with Bird on Dial, and we started talking. He was telling me about St. Louis with Clark Terry and Shorty Baker, so he saw I was interested in him, and I said, "Miles, you want to have a drink?" He says, "No, I'd like some ice cream." So we went and had ice cream, and we developed a friendship, you know, right then and there.
Miles saw a commercial opportunity and signed with Weinstock, who organized the first recording session.
He worked on the session. We had Sonny Rollins, I think, Benny Green, John Lewis. It came out very nice. And right away, it achieved my goal that he got on the jukeboxes, he got radio play, and from then on, it was all straight ahead with Miles. See, we had a very good rapport, me and Miles, because he trusted me. Right from the early recordings, he'd say to me, "How's that, Bob?" And I'd say, "Okay." And he'd just say, "Next." Miles did make my company world famous. He wasn't my biggest seller. I had artists that outsold him, but Miles Davis was in a class by himself. And then we did Walkin', which is an old Gene Ammons song, you know, funky blues. And to me, that was my best record. I say that's my best record, Walkin' by Miles.